मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेस टॉपिक इज मस्कुलर सिस्टम, द मसल्स फॉर्म द मस्कुलर सिस्टम। एंड इन ह्यूमन बॉडी देयर आर 656 टू 800 मसल्स आर देयर। सो द वी ऑल नो बोन्स दे कैनॉट मूव दैमसेल्स, सो दे रिक्वायर द हेल्प ऑफ द मसल्स टू मूव। सो वी ऑल नो द बोन्स आर जॉइंट विद द बोन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ टफ फाइबर्स, स्ट्रॉन्ग टफ फाइबर्स विच आर नोन एज लिगामेंट्स। एंड हियर द मसल्स आर जॉइंट विद द बोन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फाइबर्स विच आर नोन एज टेंडन्स। सो व्हाट आर टेंडन्स? टेंडन्स आर द स्ट्रॉन्ग फाइबर्स विच हेल्प अ मसल टू जॉइन विद अ बोन। सो व्हाट वी कैन से, देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मसल्स वी कैन फाइंड इन केस ऑफ द ह्यूमन बीइंग। सो द थ्री मसल्स आर वॉलेंटरी मसल्स, इनवॉलेंटरी मसल्स एंड द कार्डियक muscles. So these are the three different types of muscles. Now when a muscles help bone to move, that is bones and muscles together help us to move the organ, but the muscles, one muscles cannot work alone. So a pair of muscles work together in our body. So that two types of muscles are biceps and triceps. So this pair of this biceps and triceps muscles help us to move our body parts. Upper arm, we can see the two types of muscles are there. One is bicep and the tricep. So we can see the bicep in the front part of the upper arm and the tricep at the back. So that means if we close our hand tightly and then bend our arm at the elbow and we touch the shoulder, then what we will see, that the biceps that are joined to the arm, the biceps that are joined to the arm in front, it contracts. So when the muscle contracts, it becomes shorter and thicker, and we can feel a swollen region. We can feel here a swollen region and inside our upper arm, and this is due to the contraction of the biceps. And at that time, what happened to the tricep? At the back, the tricep, it relaxes. And when a muscle relaxes, it becomes longer and thinner. So it becomes longer and thinner. And the tricep, we can see, it becomes shorter and thicker. Now, if we straighten our arm, then what we will see? We will see the bicep, it becomes shorter and thinner. That's why we can say bicep relax. And what we will see? We will see the tricep, it becomes shorter and thicker. So we can say the tricep, it contracts. So the tricep contracts. So what we can say, that our arm movements are controlled by the two muscles, biceps and the triceps. As I already said, that a muscle cannot work alone, it requires its partner. So if one muscle, it push back, pulls the muscles, then its partner, it push back the bone. Let us study the movement in another animals like a fish. If you see a fish has a streamlined body The body is covered with waterproof skins and have fins. So, the streamlined body and the fins of a fish help it to move in water and also to maintain the balance of the body. The tail fin helps a fish to change the direction when moving in water. Now, how does a fish move? The fish moves in a wave-like manner. It moves like a wave-like manner, and this movement is only possible due to the presence of flexible backbone. So a fish has a backbone which is flexible. So due to the flexible backbone, this wave-like movement is possible in case of a fish. So during the swimming, the front part of the fish, it moves its body, or because it moves or it curves to one side, and the tail part in the opposite side. Now the fish forms, automatically the fish forms a loop. So the fish forms a loop or a curve, and then quickly the body changes its position. Then what happens? The body and the tail curves to the other side. The body is one side, again the tail curves towards the another side from another loop. So this produces a jerk in the body of the fish and pushes the body forward. So the series of this type of jerks, a number of jerks are, that is made the loop, they form the loops by changing their body position. A jerk is produced. So a series of jerks are produced and the fish move forwards. So this is all about how does a fish move in water.